Hey you, and welcome to my channel. My name is Sina and my aim is to improve your drawings just like others have done for me when I just started out. Somebody asked me to do a review on the Conti à Paris pastel pencils, just like I did with the Stabilo Carbotello pastel pencils. If you haven't seen that video yet and you're deciding which pencils to buy, go check out that video and I'll have the link pop into the screen as well as I put it into the description below. For starters, I have to say that I don't really use these pencils that much as my others, so to get a better feel for this brand, I decided to draw something mostly with these pencils. Conti is a huge name in the art world and particularly in pastel. They provide both pastel pencils and pastel sticks, which are rectangular sticks of pure pastel pigment. I might dabble a bit into the sticks, but I have yet to see what I'm drawing. First up is their packaging and presentation. In total, there are 48 colors available for purchase. It's possible to buy these open stock, and having the option to buy something open stock is wonderful, as some of your colors will wear down much faster than others. They also have sets available. The Conti à Paris pastel pencils come in sets of 12, 24, and 48. When it comes to the casing of these pencils, I wish I could show you, but I must have found it too flimsy and just put it in the waste. Let me pull up a picture of what it should look like. Now for me personally, I don't think the packaging matters as it's all about how a pencil performs. Now let's have a look at the pencil itself. They come with an 8mm barrel and approximately a 5mm core, and although a lot of other pencils have roughly the same barrel diameter, or only slightly less, somehow to me they just don't fit nicely into my hand. This is strictly my opinion and how something feels to me. Now all in all, for packaging and presentation, I'd give this a 3 out of 5. Moving on to my second category. Their color range and light fastness. So, as I already said, they have a total of 48 colors, which is amongst the lowest side when you compare them to other brands. Now, the total amount of colors doesn't determine everything. What matters as well, and maybe even more so, is the color range. Speaking out of my own preferences here, and as someone who loves to create realistic pieces and in particular animals, I'm not happy with their colors. If you look at the biggest set, they have lots of different blues, greens, and reds. This may be ideal for other artists, but I'm using way more grays and browns in the realistic animals I create. So this isn't a set I would recommend to animal artists if I base it only on the colors. Then when it comes to their light fastness, this isn't as easy as with the other brands because it's not listed on the pencils, nor on the packaging. You actually have to go to their website for this, and where you can find a color chart naming the actual pigment in their range plus their light fastness rating. When it comes to their scores, they work with a star system. Now let me pull that up for you here. It goes from 1 to 4, and according to the makers, this goes from limited to excellent light fastness. They have 30 pencils in the good and upwards category, making them good enough to work on originals or commissions. Although I think 30 pencils is better suited to supplement your colors than acting as a base. So for color range and light fastness, I would give them a 1 out of 5. Next up, their visual appeal and performance. This is what you want to know. How good are these pencils? Now, I have to be honest with you, I have the full set at home, but I only use them on occasions, so I didn't have a lot of experience working with them, but to make up for that, I drew something completely made with these pencils. I did find them to have excellent pigmentation, but these are very soft pencils, and the funny thing with that is because they are so soft, they actually lay down too much pastel on your paper. Now, I'm talking about this out of the perspective of someone who creates realistic pieces. As such, you want the vibrant colors, but you also don't want your pastel paper to clog up early, because otherwise you can't lay down lots of layers which you need to create that realism. But because they are so soft, they did blend perfectly, so I think they would be the perfect set to create an out-of-focus background. A disadvantage of this would be that getting a fine line is very hard. And another thing I have to mention is that they are a pain to sharpen. As you can see here, I tried to sharpen this white pencil and it broke off all the time, which was extremely annoying. I ended up using just a blunt pencil because I was so frustrated that I wouldn't try to sharpen it anymore. So because of all this, I would give them a 2 out of 5 for this category. Finally, for the last category, let's talk money and value. When it comes to their price, I just looked them up on Jacksons to get an idea. Note that these are the prices I found while I'm making this video in January 2021. If you buy them in a set, you'll roughly pay. While open stock, you'll pay. So with these pencils, you definitely get a discount when you buy them in a set. Now, given that you pay for the pastel pencils from Carondash or for the pit pastels from Faber-Castell, these are cheap pencils. And honestly, I think that they give you what you pay for, but nothing more. I think you are better off getting Carbotellos instead. You can check them out in the review I did on them earlier, and I'll make that video pop up in your screen, and I'll put it in the description below. You are going to pay just a little more for these, but you get a pencil that is so much better all round. So for money and value, I would give the Conti à Paris pencils a 1 out of 5. Now in conclusion, I'd say this definitely isn't my favorite pencil. As an upside to this pencil, I'd say they blend perfectly, making them very suited for different applications, including the blurry background I mentioned before. They also have a very affordable price, but that is all about the good I can say about them. The same softness that allows such great blending also gets in the way of the ability to get down smooth lines, plus the irritation they cause me when sharpening and the poor quality of the color range. The cons to these pencils are just too big to me. Overall, I give these pencils a 2 out of 5. Just as a footnote, these are all my personal opinions, and keep in mind that I'm talking about what I'm looking for as a realistic animal artist. If you like to draw landscapes, for example, your needs could be quite different. I actually think these are great pencils for landscape artists if the sharpening wasn't so annoying. If you find this review helpful, or if there is anything in particular you'd like me to do a review on, let me know in the comments below, and as always, your input is highly appreciated. I hope you liked this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and make sure to subscribe to my channel. I really appreciate your support, as this helps to grow my channel and reach other people like yourself. Hope to see you again next Friday, and in the meantime, have a great week.